Hello, in the earlier part, we have seen about the meaning of MNC, how the MNC works there, which companies can be called the MNC. Now, in this part, we are going to see how the MNC interlinks the production, the interlinking of the production across the countries. Across the countries means throughout the globe, how they works, that we are going to see in this part. MNC works in a different way to expand their business. Whenever the MNC tries to set up their business, they first looks the factors of the production, whether the factors of production are in favor to them or not, in which region they are having the factors of production in their favor, that region only chosen or that location only chosen by the MNCs. The first one, we look the close to the market. They look the closeness to the market. Then they look the skilled and unskilled labor. In which region they get the skilled and unskilled labor, not only skilled and unskilled labor, they look on low cost wages. They should available on the low cost. And again they look the other factors which they are having available or not, like the communication, connectivity, transportation. If these all are having available, natural resources, raw material in that region, that location is will be favored by the MNC to choose set up their factory. Along with that, they looks the government policies also. The government policies should in favor which protects the interest of the MNC. If the government policies are not protecting the interest of the MNC in that country, these MNC are not setting up their plants. They set up their plants only in that country where the government protects their interest. Somewhere we have seen with the SEZ, how the SEZ is working there, or in the SEZ region, the MNC are getting favor to establish their plant. Now we look at the investment. Any plant, whenever it is needing to set, it need some capital, permanent capital which is invested there. When any plant is going to start, that time the investment is in. When any plant is started there, that time the investment is needing to buy the asset, land, building, machines, and other equipment. This is called investment. The company is investing money to buy the asset, land, that is the building, machine, and other equipment. This is called investment. And when this investment is done by MNC, that is called foreign investment. Whenever one is investing his money, that time he always in hope to earn more profit. The MNC also in hope of the earning more profit. Now we will see how the MNC works here. This is a way we have seen in which location the MNC will set up their factory. There are three ways the MNC expand their business. The one is they make joint partnership with the local companies. Other, they take over the local production. And the next third way is there. They give orders to the small producers, collects their production and sells in the brand of the MNC. These are the three ways the MNC expand their business. The first one we will see, making partnership or starting business in jointly. MNC set up production jointly with some of the local companies of these countries. The benefit, it is beneficial to the both. To the local company also it is beneficial, to the MNC also it is beneficial. how it is beneficial to the local company. First we will see. It is in a two way benefits to the local company. The one way, it supports the capital, to stand the capital to get more production. Benefits to the local company of such joint production is twofold. First, MNC can provide money for additional investment. For additional investment, MNC supports here, like buying new machines. New machines can be bought to take more production or faster production. And second is here, the latest technology. MNC can bring latest technology, and with it, it helps to get more production to the local companies. How it is beneficial to the MNC? MNC get local support, local labor, and interlinking with the market easily. So it helps to the MNC also. The one picture is here given. You can read this picture. This is the owner of MNC. What he is saying here? Higher wages and better condition of the work. It is always demanded by the labor. If like these things are started, that time these owners start to think to shift their business, because it is a very expensive, or the cost of production increases. Whenever the cost of production increases in that region, the MNC not set up their business or the production. So here we have seen one way to expand business by the MNC. Now we'll see the second way. What happens in the other way, we will see here in the second. It is the mostly used the form. The MNC not make joint production. They always try to take over the local brands, local companies, because they are having strong wealth. With this strong wealth, they buy up the local companies and expand their business. But the most common route for MNC investment is to buy up local companies and then to expand production. MNC with huge health can quite easily do so. They are having huge health, huge capital. That is why they can do it very easily. One example is here given, the Cargill Foods. The Cargill Food is the MNC of America. American MNC. This has bought over smaller Indian companies such as Parag Foods. The one example is given here. The Parag Foods is taken over by this Cargill Foods. Parag Foods was already having large marketing network and various parts in the various part of India. It was well reputed brand that is used by the Cargill Foods. The wealth of this company is very large. It is in compare to the budget of any developing country. So this wealth power can make influence in the market. The MNC uses this power to acquire the market. The next remaining way, we will see how the MNC take over or make interlinking of the production. The large MNC in a developed countries place order for production with smaller producers. This MNC gives order to the small producers for the production. Maybe it is making of the shoes, making of football. Like these productions, for this production, the MNC is a placing order to the different small producers. Cottage industries we have seen. In this part, in this way, the cottage industries are working, and these MNCs are giving order to these people, those who are working in these small businesses. Separately, they are sparse from each other. They are not unitedly working. Such as garments, footwear, sport items are examples where the MNC is working in this way. Production is carried out by a large number of small producers around the world. The production are supplied to the MNC, which then sell these under their own brand names to the customer. The MNC is using their brand to sell it to their customer. These large MNC have tremendous power to determine. These MNC are having tremendous power to determine price. How much price they want to give, they give. To handle quality, delivery, and to handle the labor condition. In these distant producers, the producers are not at one place, the producers are at the distant places, and it is collected by the one MNC. So here we have seen how the MNC is working. The way is here shown. These ladies are here in the Ludhiana. Women at home in the Ludhiana making football for large MNC. So the work is done. It helps to the local economy also. It gives works to the people who are working in the cottage industry. And it supplies production to the MNC. So it is beneficial to the both. Thus we see that there are a variety of ways in the MNC are spreading their production and interacting with local producers. The different ways we have seen in this part, the MNC is completing their production and making interaction with the local people. It is happening across the globe by setting up partnership with local companies, one way, using the local companies for supply, second way, closely competing with the local companies, this is the another way, are buying up them, and MNC are exerting a strong influence on production at these distant locations. The distant locations are exerted, and the production is exerted from the distant places throughout the globe, throughout the world. In this way, the MNC interlinks production across the countries. It is not happening in one country. It happens in the different countries of the globe, in the world. So this is called interlinking of production across the countries. Production in these widely dispersed locations is getting interlinked. So we have seen the different places production is interlinked by the MNC, what ways they adopt there and how they works to expand the business and how it is beneficial. Again, in detail, we are going to see about it in the next part also.